Chad gave me a little bit of time here at the end to talk about the MCC-216, the multiple classic computer from arcaderetrogaming.com. And I am not a paid spokesman. I'm just volunteering to show off this machine at various user group meetings. This was shown at the Commodore Vegas Expo, and it was also, it's being shown here. And I think I'm going to show it at the next arcade show, that arcade party, SC3 arcade party down in Southern California in a few months. So enjoy. You can see here that the board, and I'm not expert, I'm not expert on the MCC-216. It's this little box, if you can see it past the everything here. This little box houses all of the FPGs that run in it. You can open it up with, it's just held together by four screws. You can look inside and see all the FPGs inside of it. It's running at 25 megahertz, but it doesn't say what kind of 25 megahertz that is. So I don't know if that's a 68,000 25 megahertz machine, or is it a 68030 running at 25 megahertz, or whatever it is. Go ahead.
All right.
We have an interruption. Brian, go ahead, Brian.
I just wanted to say thank you to all the SAC volunteers. SAC volunteers, can you wave for us, please?
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much. And also, if you appeal for help as we're pounding on the door, that would really be funny. Because there's a lot of stuff going on.
So up here we have the cores that are available for the MCC-216. You can only load, well, I found that you can only load about 5 cores into the machine before it runs out of FPGA space there. There is an Apple II core also, but it's very beta, and it doesn't have anything for it. So I've loaded up the ones that do have games for the machine. For example, if you go to the Atari 2600 core, you cursor down, you press enter, and you get all of these games with the Atari 2600, all these good old games here. And you have an entire list here. I'm unfamiliar with the method of loading in Atari 2600 games, because the instructions online are not very concise or complete. These are the games that came in the machine as it was. To get out of this menu, and I haven't figured out any other way to get out of the menu except to turn the on and off button in the back. So there is no reset button in front. There's an on and off button in the back. And we're back to this again. You could see that it has an Amiga VGA NTSC core. It has an Amiga VGA PAL core. It has a Commodore 64 NTSC core and a Commodore 64 PAL core also. This is the MCC-216 VGA version. They do have an S-Video version, but I've heard that the S-Video version is not very... It has troubles with S-Video. So I looked for the less troublesome one. I requested the less troublesome one to demonstrate. The VGA version. Let's go to... Well, let's look at this very quickly. Commodore 64, the PSC. And it's scanning the SD card. These are the games on the SD card. These games are from the C64 Forever CD, and in the box they do include a C64 Forever CD. There is a process, a way to get the games, the RP3 games off the CD, off the C64 Forever CD, and onto a format that the MCC-216 can understand. However, I'm unfamiliar with the process of doing that. These games were already loaded onto the SD card, so I'm not touching it. Okay, let's get out of the C64 NTSC core. Let's go to the meat and potatoes here. We'll go to the Amiga VGA NTSC core here. And I've only loaded a few ADFs into it. Okay? So we have here a few ADFs that I've loaded in. Let's see, this one was loaded in at the Commodore Vegas Expo. It's just a kind of walkout game. What also? There's Star Wars, The Empire Strikes Back. And I found out this version of Star Wars, this ADF here, it seems to be going in a cycle as it's decompressing. So it's either a bad crack, or maybe it doesn't understand NTSC and it wants the Amiga PAL version. But I'm in NTSC mode right now. Let's run this one here. This is the easiest one. This is just a little game here. So we push enter. We mark it like that with a number. And it will do multiple, if you have a multiple sides to a disk, if you have multiple ADFs. So for example, if this were like side disk 2, you'd mark that. This were disk 3, you'd mark that. And would play all of those. But those are just individual games. Those are not multiple disk games. So we'll undo those. Just cursor and enter. So that's the game. That is the game we decided right there. We'll go to start the Amiga Kickstart. And you have to put in an Amiga Kickstart 1.3 ROM into here. Okay, load in the Kickstart. We'll load up the game. And it's not the fastest in loading. Okay? So it seems to take its time as if it were disk loading. There we go. So we have an Amiga screen with a little mouse. At least in this ADF. Mega Ball or Drift. F1 or F2. So you push F1. We have this little warning again. Come on, get off the warning. Okay, as I wait for it to decompress, there it goes. Okay, now it's going through loading in certain things. Click to continue. And here's our game. Well, that was bad. Try again. Okay, I blame the surface of this table. I don't blame myself. It's the surface of the table that's making my mouse not move fast enough. I should have done that. Oh well. So that is Mega Ball. Okay, so that's one thing there. So this has not been fully tried out with bunches and bunches of games. Okay, I think it's thinking about something. Well, we'll get out of it. We'll try one more game, and that's it for my brief demonstration of the MCC-216. We'll go back to VGA NTSC for the Amiga. We'll go to good old Star Wars, and start, enter, go. This takes a little bit longer to load because I guess it's a bigger thing. So if you have not seen it at the table here, I will pass around the box. It says you get this like Competition Pro joystick with the system. However, I got an Atari joystick in the box when it came to me. So go ahead, pick them up. Okay, still loading, I hope.
Yeah. I found the new Division AGA2.
So I hear tell that the FPG arcade is supposed to be like the competition against the... It's supposed to be like more powerful than the MCC-216. This unit comes from, I believe, southern United States where they mail it from, and it's $200 for it. Unless you get like the bulk version, which is cheaper. Again, you can find this at arcaderetrogaming.com. Okay, well, this is Star Wars. Good old Star Wars. Start the music, start the music.
No,
okay, well, forget the music. I'm just going to start the game. Okay. Oh. Yeah, shoot the pipe on. And I prefer the Amiga version over the Commodore 64 version. The Commodore 64 version of this is just funkier with the joystick. With the mouse, it's very nice. It's smoother with the mouse. Okay. MCC-216. If you guys want to come up here and play with it, go ahead. We have a few brochures from the company here, so you can have fun.